In this Q&A video, we're going to be answering the question, where in a joist can I drill a hole? It is important to note here that our focus is specifically on the structural integrity of solid timber joists that are often encountered in older installations, rather than the engineering joists found in 70% of new builds these days. These will be addressed in another video. Well, what do the regs say about drilling through joists? Part A of the building regulations specify that buildings shall be constructed so that loads are sustained and transmitted by it to the ground, A, safely, and B, without causing such deflection or deformation of any part of the building or disproportionate collapse. Furthermore, Regulation 522.8.14 BSM 671 states that no wiring system should penetrate an element of construction that is intended to be load-bearing unless the load-bearing ability of the element remains satisfactory after such penetration. Now, these kinds of statements could lead us to a potential debate between structural engineers watching this video as to what kind of penetration would be allowable before load-bearing ability is affected. Words like neutral axis, compressive force, tensile load, geometric centers, deflection, flanges, shear force, and bending moments may begin to fly around in the comments section. However, remember that most sparks aren't trained structural engineers, and therefore must rely on guidelines such as those provided by the IET. The wording satisfactory is also somewhat ambiguous, so let us seek further clarification from IET sources such as the Electrician's Guide to the Building Regulations and On-Site Guide.
Just before Ross explains exactly what the guidance is on what we can or can't do to the joist, I've popped into the workshop to point out that all the drill bits you see in this video are made by Mandrex. To drill those holes, we used a flat spade bit with the spiral tip, perfect for making quick individual holes in joists and available singly or in sets. Where you've got a whole house of joists to drill, you might prefer the PowerXbit 4-flute auger bits instead, perfect for effective waste removal, making drilling super quick. Anyways, just before I get back to playing with these awesome bits of kit, I'll finish up watching what Ross has to say about making sure I don't drill holes in the wrong place.
So what are the guidelines? Well, the IET offers some very specific guidance on where holes and notches can be made in joists. Notches, for example, are only allowed between 0.07 to 0.25 of the span from either support and no deeper than 0.125 times the depth of the joist. However, we will investigate running cables in notch joists in a little more detail in another video. According to paragraph 10.1.1 of the Electrician's Guide to the Building Regulations, holes, however, are permitted to be drilled in solid joists, providing that they are A, no greater diameter than 0.25 times the depth of the joist, B, drilled at the neutral axis, C, not less than 3 diameters center to center apart, and finally D, located between 0.25 and 0.4 times the span from the support. So let's break these down a little further. Let's take a standard solid joist with a depth of 150mm, for example. If we do a quick calculation of 0.25 times 150mm, we will deduce that the largest diameter hole we are permitted to drill is 37.5mm. Do we go with that 38mm Mandrex Ultimate Speedxbit flatwood bit here then? Or perhaps we stick with the 32mm also on offer to be on the safe side? B. Drilled at the neutral axis. As per figure 10.1.1, this tells us that we drill our holes along the center line of the joist between the span allowed. If we do some more quick maths here, by dividing our 150mm depth by 2, we have 75mm clearance either side of our center line. Our 32mm spade bit will give us a radius of 16mm either side of that center line. Therefore, 75mm minus 16mm will leave us 59mm clearance from the top and bottom of the joist. This strategically avoids activating BSM 671 Regulation 522.6.204, where we'd then have to provide some sort of mechanical protection for our cables if we could not allow that 50mm either side, as stipulated by Regulation 522.6.201. C. Not less than 3 diameters center to center apart, and not from the edge or circumference of the first hole. If we stick with the example of the 32mm spade bit and some more quick maths, 3 times 32mm, and we would have to measure 96mm from the center of our first hole to give us the center for our next permitted hole. And finally, D. Located between 0.25 and 0.4 times the span from the support. Firstly, it is important to note that this measurement applies to either side of the joist. And secondly, as an electrician, this could mean that before we lift that board, which has obviously been lifted in the past, we might want to get our tape measure out and do some quick measurements. If we assume a span of 4,000mm, for example, then 0.25 times 4,000 and 0.4 times 4,000 equals 1,000 and 1,600 millimeters respectively. Effectively, that leaves us with a zone of 600 millimeters from exactly 1 meter on the left or the right of the supports, where we are allowed to drill our holes. You might want to think of the repercussions of not doing these quick measurements. The most drastic consequences is the failure, collapse, deflection, or deformation of any part of the building. The more likely of consequences, however, is that building control officer who pops in unannounced to inspect your notifiable works, resulting in you having to pull out all your hard work and then take any penalties on the chin for the repairs that are deemed required. Not to mention the loss in your reputation due to the delay and distrust now on hand with the client. If you don't want to see bright copper staring back at you after lifting that pre-cut tongue and groove board, perhaps snip down to the van, grab your tape measure and circular saw, and lift the board on the other side of the house. For more information on the building regs and how they impact on your electrical work, please check out our free training package to help you with your CPD by clicking the link in the description. In the meantime, happy fishing.